This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. You may have skipped the key database terminology tutorials at the start of this course where we introduced entities and tables. As a quick recap, so to make sure that we are all on the same page before discussing entities further in this tutorial, for the sake of simplicity, the term table and entity can generally be a way of expressing the same concept. So far, we know that a database has tables or entities. In this tutorial, I want to further establish the term entity and related concepts to prepare us for the first stage of our database design process. The reason why this is important because, like I mentioned, the first stage of our database design process, we are going to need to be able to identify entities. So the better we understand what an entity is, the easier this first stage will be. The first task, in my opinion, with any new terminology is to ask Google. This gives us some context. So typing in entity into Google here, a thing with distinct and independent existence. So that resonates with me because I understand the basic concept of an entity. So if we didn't, then what we now know potentially is an entity is a thing. Now, I don't like using the terminology thing, so I'm going to replace that in this tutorial and try and use the word object. So an object, an entity is an object with distinct or independent existence. Right, so I'm not entirely sure how useful that is because we now know that entity is a thing, an object, which doesn't necessarily help us understand what it is, but we can further define this potentially in the realms of databases, and potentially we can now determine that the entity represents an object, a thing, in the real world. So let's now try and connect some of the dots and apply this to our database or database terminology. We create a database to store information about objects. So here we have some crossover. An entity is an object, a thing, and our database stores things or objects. So objects can exist in the real world, or potentially they are part of our application domain. So what we're saying here is that we might model real-world objects, dogs, cats, and so on, but we might be more specific, and we need to remember that the application that we're developing the database for will have an application domain, for example. So there may be terminology and specific related things or objects within that application domain. So for example, if we were building an application for an e-commerce system, then that's our, we can describe that maybe as our domain. That's our application domain, e-commerce. So there may be different terminology, objects that relate to that specific domain, which can help us out determine and start to identify entities or objects that we want to store in our database. I always try and have at the back of my mind when I'm trying to establish entities is that entities should have attributes. Else, like I keep saying or mentioning, we have a table in our database which has nothing inside of it. So we need to keep that in mind and help that guide us when trying to determine and identify entities. As the entity is defined here in Google as a thing with distinct attributes and independent existence. The independent existence, this is suggesting that within our database, that every single entity should be unique. So we shouldn't have two entities that are the same or potentially are storing the same data. So two tables that might be storing similar data. Of course, that's going to be replication of data, but clearly this entity definition here is describing that fact. So we can bring that over to our database and now say that when we develop or identify entities, we need to make sure that they are unique within our database. So we are going to be starting the design process with the idea that we need to identify entities. So in this example here, we have a new table, entity student, and then we take the next step eventually and identify attributes. So attributes of a student, maybe a student ID, the subject that they're learning, the subject fee, a student name, for example. So what might be classed as an entity? Well, it could be a person, could be a place, any object we can store information about or anything we can store information about. So hopefully you're getting the general idea of how to potentially identify entities. It is important to remember, although I said an entity can be anything, it is important to remember we're only going to find entities in the first stages of our database design process, entities that actually need to be stored and we need to store information about. So that's important, of course. We're not going to just simply find all the entities that potentially exist within a case study and then just put them in a database. We want to be able to obviously record all the information that's appropriate for that particular scenario. So where this can get a little bit tricky is that we have tangible and intangible entities. I tend to find that students find it easier to identify the tangible entities. So for example, a car is tangible, a house, a dog, they all exist in the real world. You can touch them. And then we have intangible or more conceptual. So for example, a job, category, an address. These are not perceptible by touch. So therefore, these are intangible. However, all are potential entities. Again, how I'm determining whether it is an entity or not, these are intangible entities. So for example, a job, maybe I have a job table. Well, I just need to go through that process in my mind. Well, are there attributes associated to a job? Yeah, there's a job name. There's the, for example, how much you get paid. And then I mentioned category. Well, category could be an entity. For example, some of the attributes of a category. Well, we have a category name, for example. And then the address, that can be intangible, but it can be an entity, an address table. So what's going to be in the address table? Well, for example, the number, house number, postcode, for example. So these are all attributes potentially of these intangible entities. So let's go for a quick recap. Entities represent objects in the real world. They can be physical or conceptual, tangible or intangible. But they will have attributes. That's the important key here. I think when we're trying to develop our preliminary entity list from a scenario or from the requirements, we're thinking about finding entities which may have attributes associated to it. Because remember, entities are tables, attributes are going to be our fields in the table. I think it's also worth mentioning that entities should be unique. Now, you may have a scenario where you have different terminology for similar objects. So it's well worth going through the process of just removing any duplicate entities maybe at the start of the design process.